of the Best Innovation National Award in the year 2009, Mr. Muruganathan is best defined by his work. Let us first look at a video that demonstrates his struggle and his journey till date.
இனிமேல் வரக்கூடிய பெண்களுக்கு நீங்க தான் சொல்லணும்.
எங்களுக்கு அப்போது
I saw one day my wife is using a rackler. When I want to make a low-cost sanitary pad for my wife, with just image, what's the struggle I faced? To research the sanitary pad, first, what you need, more than the money, you need a volunteer. What volunteer? You need a women volunteer. Where you will get in India? In India, only saints will get volunteers. Every village is surrounded by thousands of women, but not me. Then I decided, why not try sanitary pad? Myself. If you found Neil Armstrong, means you know he is the man who set foot the moon on first. Like that, I am having a title, the man who wore a sanitary pad, first time in the world. That's why whenever I am seeing a woman, I am going down like anything. Previously, if you want to make the sanitary pad, you need a multi-million dollar plan. It is macro business activity. I made a small equipment, again spending 4 or 5 years. I succeeded to process the same raw material what the big corporation processing in big plant. So what I invented now, the business model, it is a sustainable livelihood activity can give to any poor woman. So any woman, they are starting this activity by locally, they can able to sell again and again in a small geographical area.
இப்ப 50 மில்லிக்கு மேலயே தண்ணி ஊத்தி இருக்கேன். நல்லா பாத்துக்கு. தண்ணி ஊத்தி வச்சா இங்க பாருங்க மேடம், ஈரமே ஆகாது. கையில ஈரம் எடுத்துட்டு பாருங்க. தண்ணி வருதா? அப்ப நம்ம ஈரம் என்ன ஆயிருது? இதோட சேர்ந்து கலந்து இப்படி ஜெல்லா மாறிடுது. யூஸ் பண்ணலாம் யாருக்கெல்லாம் ஆசையா இருக்கு?
Sanitary napkin usage penetration in India is less than 2% in rural India. Even out of this innovation, we are able to change the figure 2 into 10. It's the biggest achievement for us. Byproduct out of it, you know what is it? We are going to create a million employment for rural women.
I think they finished my job. They showed everything. They tell all the students that there is no suspense hereafter. So this is my presentation. So what is the necessity a menstrual man, a man become a menstrual man? You saw that video. This is the film directed by a Singapore director. It's a, it's a life story. They spent around 18 months, the whole crew with me, here in India, all states. They come out a film, and 52 minutes film. It's a documentary movie available. It's running all the theaters in Singapore, Malaysia, everywhere. This director made around $8 million. I just signed 4 A4 sheets 6 years back. Now I'm a little bit vibram, a little bit knowledge. I never signed anything for a full feature film. Yesterday I signed Austrian producer to make a full feature film. I asked simply 1.2 crores. They agreed. I signed. 1.2 crore for us, I asked just $200,000 and 5% revenue share on the film for lifetime across the globe. They agreed. Then finally, I made a small change in case of my options to my family. Again, they agreed. So this is a film going to come in 4 years. It is a collaboration with the Austrian government and some producer in Austria. So, next. I'm sorry, I'm using the same presentation I did in Taikan, Kerala. I don't have a time. I'm traveling 26 days in a month every day. I'm living in airports. While I'm coming back from San Francisco, I saw a movie called Up in the Air. I shocked, oh my God, I'm doing the same, what the judge is saying. Even I never took the glass out from their briefcase. I used to chain the other briefcase to travel. So people are calling, how I start the revolution. I don't have any idea of doing revolution, nothing. What I did for the last 14 years, whatever I do, a small job, I try to do in a perfect way with a heart full of affection. That small, small perfect things become a garland, then it become a revolution. That's why I say to become a revolutionist, no need to be a Napoleon or a Abraham Lincoln. Anyone, any student can be a revolutionist if you do a small thing in a perfect manner. And then today I'm going to talk this topic, being a management student. It is embedded with women empowerment. I am running a company called Jayasri Industries. See, I am not a social activist. I am not an NGO, because in India there are 2.2 million NGOs are there. How many? 2.2 million NGOs. Every 600 Indian citizen, there is an NGO. In spite, India needed a Muruganantham to address this simple problem. So I am running a company called Jayasri Industries. I am an entrepreneur for profit. In spite, I am able to do a lot of social change. So what I am talking, the topic is beyond marketing. I am having a company. In my company, I don't have marketing department. I don't have the stupid marketing manager. So in spite how I spread across India and 17 other countries, I'm targeting, today somebody come there to pick up at airport. I spend 1.5 hours in a nearby Sagara hotel with the team, where I plan to reach 70 countries within 2015 December. A small roadmap we did, eating with three Italys and the roadmap with the Bombay team. So how I did, what is called beyond marketing is a topic. So every fortnight I used to get an award given by at least for finally a Rotary Club. But whomever they come forward to give award, something, certification, I used to beg them on what criteria, on what metrics you are giving the award. Usually they will say, Muruga, if you are not deserved, then who else? In Tamil, I don't know, ungulukku therilena yaarukku therathu. This is the metric or the criteria. But recently I selected by Time magazine. I asked the same with the Time magazine. So you selected with some celebrities, some many presidents of nation among Muruga. So on what criteria? Then they become serious. Are you really serious? You want to know that. And they said, Muruganantham, you are under surveillance for last 18 months. US means there is surveillance now always. With the agency, I under surveillance for 18 months, and they given some 20, 30 points. But finally they concluded, Muruga, you converted a social problem into successful livelihood. That's why you are sharing the dais with Obama, Putin, everyone in New York. That too in Times Center, Lincoln Center, Times Square. So suddenly I'm skipping. 90% of women in India are not using sanitary pads. That was, this is what I criticized from 2004. You just go back in all newspaper, magazines. Suddenly after 2005, everyone talk about women's personal hygiene. So because of the invention, because I criticized central government in Delhi, not in Mumbai. Then the Home Department warned me, don't talk without any evidence or source or something they said. But I said, I used to work for thousands of villages. You call it as a sample packet survey something. I am having an authentic figure. Then they get frustrated. They call some AC Nelson somebody. I don't know how many million they spend. They took around 2 years. They come out a figure. In India, only 12% of women are using sanitary towel. See, Muruga told 10%, they told 12%. Then I further argued, 12% means you include all the super metros like Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata, everything. You pull out the metros out, the figure go down to less than 5%. But while I'm using the slide in this hall, there are many girls in the hall, nothing will happen. But while I'm using the same slide in France or in London or in Tokyo, are in Lebanon, the whole hall get punctured. Shh, oh my God, that's bush. Because in the women in the West, they are not able to even image, if the women not using a menstrual pad or a menstrual tampons, what they are going to use? They are not able to image. But India, why is nothing is happening? You know, if the women are not using sanitary towel, maybe she is going to use a rag cloth. That's why you take it as simple. Simple. But in our experience, we saw many part of India, what they are using, these are all the sanitary towels they are using. Sawdust, dry tree leaves, newspaper as even sand, a yellow color of sand. At the maximum, in northeast one part of that state, the tribal women, if they are having menstruation, they are going and sitting on a stalk of hay. I told this in an interview in a Forbes magazine. They come out a special article on, title is Women Sitting on Hay. What is the use? You are making thousands of tanks, these flights, F-16, bombers, stupid, useless. First provide the sand repair to the women, then you send Mars, Moon, everything to this guy. Then there is a warning. I used to put the slide, any country I speak. Still now I don't know that pronunciation for Sechechri, Sochechri, Nachechriyal. For next 30 minutes I am going to speak a wrong English, I don't know English. Because I am a school dropout, my background is only 8th standard, not even in a convent, in an orthodox hut in a South India. Now I am sharing dais with Obama, Bill Gates, that Gates, that Gates, all Gates. Okay. Why I am saying this boldly, if something, if you say, if you have a braveness to say, I don't know, then you are a man, you are a girl. Then you are getting a chance to learn further. But in India, nobody says, I don't know. Everybody become a master of all subjects. They said everything they know. If you ask anyone astronomy, yeah, I know what cloud you are. If you know something medicine, they will tell. So don't try to be a master of all subjects. You say whatever people are asking you, I don't know. Clearly I don't know. You see the magic, you will learn every minute. So that's why I'm saying, I don't know. I'm saying then I'm getting the license from the audience because I said already. What happened in India, even that in our family used to say, my daughter is cook everything, all items she cook. The moment she got married, gone into other house, the mother-in-law knows she don't know cooking. Everything, so don't start with no. You say, I don't know, then there is a chance of learning. Then this is my presentation. Because I no need to confuse that audience. If they are venture capitalists with lot of intersection circles, east-west graph, multiple graphs, it's a clear slide. So the moment I'm using this slide, how many of the mind says, why this man is putting an empty slide or blank slide? Out of it, you can measure your level of maturity. Because in this world, nothing is empty. Even this space is filled with some spiritual neurons. Because you are breathing that, you are unstable, not because of food you eaten. And secondly, I'm saying, whatever you want to do, something creative, or you want to develop, you want to do some big things, your education or your background or your wealth, nothing is important. Clarity is very important. In mind, the clarity is important. Luckily, I never get studied. My mind always clear. Okay. The moment you do 2 PhD, 3 PhD, you know, you're always in confusion stage. Even have some barathas, some mixed vegetables, some sabji, you'll get confusion while you can take. Where alu or mixed sabji. That's why clarity is very, very important. So that's why you try to make your mind in a particular status, clarity, then you try to do anything. Then out of it, I'm a school dropout. I'm son of a handloom weaver. That too in an orthodox city called Coimbatore. Still now, my city is very safe for girls. No girl will smoke in the street, no girl go to puff. So it is a very, very safe city in India, Coimbatore. But it is very conventional, so no freedom. Such a city I born, suddenly my father died in a road accident. Then my mother became a caretaker. You just imagine, the moment a housewife became a caretaker of a family, the only choice is to become a farm worker. She became a farm worker to the nearby farm for the wages of 5 rupees. Because she used to saw a lot of Tamil movies, acted by a lot of heroines. My mother having 2 daughters and myself 1 son. With the 5 rupees earning, she want to make me son into engineer, 1 daughter into doctor, and another daughter into collector. But because it is only possible in screens, but not in real life, that's why I stopped my schooling to support my mother. Then I became a welder in a small welding workshop. Then later I became a malik to a small workshop. Even after seeing many men, they are suffering and it is very difficult to manage, a little bit risky. After knowing everything, I also did the same mistake. One day I got married. That to arrange marriage. You just imagine. But it is a very thrilling. I saw one day to see the bride through window, not even they are not allowed to talk. I saw a Kareena Kapoor like a rosy girl inside the room. Then I thank to Ganpat, everyone, oh, you for a well-dry, give me a Karuna Kapoor like a girl. Then, after marriage in second day, I saw the Karuna Kapoor become a dull black girl. I don't know what magic that in makeup they did. But being a newly married guy, those days it is very thrilling. So we used to know each other after marriage only. It's very thrilling. Nowadays, the younger generation you are missing. Because the moment you got engaged with this stupid and gag gets, you are talking everything. Then you, after marriage, nothing to talk. Recently, I... So recently, I met a newly couple, married couple to my home. I saw the bride is talking in this window, the bridegroom is talking in this window. Then I said, what is this? We talk everything before that. So what is advice? The moment you got engaged, at least change your mobile number or just switch off your mobile number after your marriage. Then only you'll get the real charisma of the marriage. What is the charisma of the marriage? It's a thrilling to impressing each other. So what is it you're doing? Anyone, there are some elder people here. If I ask, go back to your early marriage, this is what you did. Even if you're a CEO of a company or a president of the nation, if you are newly married, your important job is impress your new wife. That's why I try to impress my new wife with a 5 rupees plastic pendant, 10 rupees glass bangle, not giving in direct. I used to gift wrap, there is a ribbon. Then I say, close your eyes, Santi, turn left, turn right. This way, okay. So this way I'm giving a value addiction for the 5 rupees classic packet. It is called value addiction. Because I'm not a Shah Rukh Khan to give every time a diamond pendant. So this way my life gone. Then without a formal MBA from any institute, I am managing my wife and my mother at the same house for the 14th consecutive. So many managers, they failed even to do that. That's what I doubt. Many times I used to get a call from my middle or management friends. I'm Suresh calling. Yes, Suresh, please come down to this hotel. I used to search the Suresh in all meeting halls, buffet halls. Finally, I saw inside the bar by 6 o'clock in the evening. Then I asked, why Suresh by 6 o'clock we're in the bar? It's a hell, man. Recently, we bought the apartment for 2 crores. No, I'm not talking about the apartment, the people. How many? Wife and mother. Even he is not able to manage his own wife and mother, how are we going to manage a big company? It is really a question mark. Because management is not taught in institute, it is beginning from the joint family. Joint family is the first place to learn management, because management means not like this rigid, it is completely flexible like this. So don't try to be a manager like this, you will be fail. Be a manager like this, you will be succeed. If you be like this, then you will be die one day like a Maruti Udyog manager. So that's why. Because I'm saying, manager is killed by workers in Maruti Udyog Limited. The management get failed. 2 HR managers killed in my city, in Coimbatore. These are the failure of management, because management is not in the books. It is a human relation something. Luckily, because I'm uneducated, everything, the management is inbuilt in my mind. No need to disturb with that, everything. Then with that, I am managing my wife and mother. So many managers have failed. And secondly, there is a problem. Whenever the interview happening now, it is unnatural. I never found a natural thing. 4-5 people, they're wearing a full suit. And one girl or boy will come. They will knock the door. May I come in? Then they will say, yes, come in. See, the interview is happening in Mumbai. It should be asked, they're Marathi. Everything is artificial. In the panel also, they don't know 100% English. The candidate also don't know 100% English, because there is no British. Both are Indians. But why you are knocking his door with, may I come in? Then everything will happen. Then the panel will ask questions. Then I saw the candidate always carrying this much of file. MBA certificate is only one sheet. What is carrying in the big file? I saw many people, they are carrying even the lemon and spoon certificate. Nah? In the school you want the spoon and lemon. That certificate also. Because something will happen in the panel. Then the panel also, they were very serious, because I observed everything. Then one man is there asking, what is the capital of London? And I get shot, sir, London is already capital for Britain. No, no, we are checking the alertness of the candidate. I said, so, sir, you don't waste the time like this. Just only one question you ask with the candidate. Are you married? If the candidate say yes, are you living with your mother and wife on the same house? Again, he says, you ask how many years. Anyone say 3 years, straight away appoint to any post in the corporate, they will manage. Now, many companies are following. They simply, are you married? Yes. Are you living with the mother and wife at the same house? How many years? 3 years. Selected. Go. you can ask any of you in campus, it will happen one day. Then you understand, oh, this is Muruga's advice. You can take it. So this is what happened. But one day I saw my wife trying to use a rag cloth. Something he began carrying. I thought she is playing with me. Then I asked her, what is this? She's replying like slapping on my cheek. It's none of your business. Usually the South Indian wives don't say like this. Then I get shocked. I saw a rag cloth. But what I got on a particular day, again I'm getting a chance. Why not offer a sanitary pad packet as a gift? This is what I got on the particular day. Then I went to buy the sanitary napkin packet from the shop. Even now, if you want to buy all the brands, the only available place is medical shop. I went to the medical shop in my small village. The shop was asking, what brand do you want? Who knows brand and all? I just point out a packet into the showcase. What he did on the day, he took that packet, he wrapped an old newspaper, he closed and he looked left, right, he handed me like a smuggling product. Why? Because he did like this, it became a curiosity on me. What is inside the packet? If you open, something will jump out from the packet. Because of it, I opened the packet. I'm taking out a sanitary pad, an 8-inch length white substance, maybe made of cotton. While I'm saying the same, in any hall, I used to ask the men in the sitting the hall, how many of the men in this hall you ever touched the sanitary pad in your life? Then only few, we are all students, we forget. But even they are married, even it is in New York or in Washington, everywhere, only few hands. Even Bill Gates never raised his hand. Because of that, Manmohan Singh don't know about sanitary pad. Ghulam Nabi Azad don't know about sanitary pad. That's why the penetration of sanitary pad usage is less than 2% in our country. 99% of them, they won't use. Luckily, I came to know everything on the early marriage time. Then I saw that 8-inch length substance, white color. I am the son of handloom weaver. Maybe white means 10 gram cotton. Raw material cost in 1997 is 10 paise. But I bought the product for 6 rupees. Then I just calculated like a X factor, like a venture capitalist, multiples. 10 paise to 6 rupees. Then I thought, why not make a low cost sanitary pad for my wife? All started from my wife. Then I went to the nearest medical textile mill. I bought the cotton web. Then I cut it into a rectangle. There is a stiffness cloth in the cuff and the collar. I used the same cloth to wrap that cotton. I made a similar napkin what I bought from the shop in 2 days. But now the problem is, if I want to do a small research in my workshop, I can very well I can do. Now I did that research in sanitary pad, where I can check. I need a women volunteer. As I said, in India only Guruji, Swamiji surrounded by hundreds of women. This Muruganantham never got a single woman volunteer. The only available choice or victim is my wife, Santi. As usual, I gift wrap the 2 napkins. I said, close your eyes, Santi. Then I put the napkin. The moment I opened the packet, she gets shocked. Then, very cleverly, I selected one fine Friday to hand over the sanitary pad. Why? Because, you know, I don't know what is happening with women's body, what is menstruation, nothing, I don't know. But only one, I'm having gloomy idea. In my village, there is a goddess temple. In front of the temple, every Friday, women will assemble. Only few will enter in the temple. Rest all, they will wait outside. Out of it, I thought women are getting menstruation Friday. That's why I selected one Friday to hand over the sanitary pad. Then I asked my wife, use it and give the feedback instantly. Then Santi says, no, it's not like that. You have to wait for some time. Then only understand it's happening monthly once. Why I'm saying this? In India, many men, they become married, husband, father, grandfather, great-grandfather, and then they will die without knowing what is happening in the partner's body. Luckily, it came to my early marriage. But being this menstruation, it is a taboo, it is a cultural barrier. Nobody ever talk. What is the subject I'm talking in that institute? A wife never talk to husband, daughter never talk to mother, friends, they don't talk each other. Earlier, I thought it is the taboo in developing nations like India. Now I'm traveling across the globe. I used to ask from Catherine in France, Catherine, do you talk about menstruation with your husband? Instantly, she replied, Muruga, why should I talk about my menstruation with my husband? So menstruation is a taboo, not only in India, around the globe. Nowhere the women, they're talking openly about this. Then even after using my wife and sisters, they used to say the napkin is not good, they won't elaborate. See, now I'm trying to co-create a product. Unless otherwise I'm getting the feedback from the customer, I'm not able to create my product in a correct way. But I used to get the feedback like Maniratnam film, yes, no, TK, AK, one word answer. That too, they will turn to the wall, feedback. I have to see the back. Then there are a lot of goddess pictures and Anjaneya, Ganesha all over the walls. Whenever I'm talking about menstruation, either Anjaneya will watch or Ganesha will watch. My wife says, in front of Ganesha, you're talking like this. all the walls, when I'm telling that in foreign, we used to hang our God on wall. They said, why you're hanging your God? I said, not hanging, putting nails on the wall, then hanging, I told. They surprised. Then one day they want, if you're going on continue the research, we're going to tell my mother. If my mother knows, it's become a problem. Then without knowing my wife, I tried to use the medical college girls. It is 40 kilometers away from my small workshop. But even the medical college girls, they're having a taboo. Again, the same problem, one word answer. Then I tried to come out in white paper, one side, what I want to ask the question in my language, Tamil. Opposite is a blank side, they have to write that answer. I thought it's a beautiful idea done by me. Now only you know it is a feedback seat. Those days I thought in front of mirror, Muruga, how you are thinking? You are so clever. Now I know it's a feedback seat I designed 10, 12 years. But that too I saw only three girls because of sympathy on me. Only three girls filled everything for the rest of the girls. That's why I fed up. Then I decided to wear sanitary napkin myself. Then I wore a sanitary pad. I made an artificial uterus in a football bladder. I filled animal blood. Then I tied here. There is a tube connection to the sanitary pad and to the bladder. While I'm cycling and walking, I made a small press. A dosage of blood will go to the sanitary pad which I'm wearing. While I'm doing this, there is a blood stain on my clothes and there is a foul smell around me. In 15 days, the cord blood will give the foul smell. So you see, the complete research I did in a small village called Papanaik in Budur, not in Las Vegas or San Francisco. Something is happening around me, I never realized. One day Shanti serving us, he is telling, I'm going to ask one thing, don't mistake in me. I said, go ahead. No, many of my friends saying you are roaming with medical college girls. I said, because I had the matter. I said, no, the main gate of the college became Karab. I went to repair the gate. She never convinced. She said, I'm getting bored. I want to go to my parents' home for a few days. I dropped her. She never come back. On 20th day, I got a divorce notice from my wife. That's the first accolade I got. But I took the separation. Before she coming back, I want to complete the research. Because my mother is with me, there is no problem for Kana. Then further, at the maximum, one point of time, I used to collect used pad from the girls. Because why it has become so tough, this is the domain is monopolized by Procter & Gamble and Johnson for half a century. No one knows outside what is happening, what they are using, nothing. Like how the soft drink industry is monopolized by Pepsi and Coke, this is the domain is monopolized by Procter & Gamble and Johnson. That's why I'm struggling with material itself. Then collecting that used napkin from medical college girl and spreading all in the backyard of my home in a small 10 by 10 thatched room. I spread everything on Saturday evening by tying my nose with the handkerchief because of great foul smell, 10, 20 girls used napkin. I'm waiting for Sunday morning. The moment Sunday morning, I'm very seriously watching what happened to my napkin, company napkin. I never realized my mother is coming back. She thought son is cleaning chicken for Sunday. The woman come and saw the substance, she never, nothing she did, she started crying. Somebody did on my son something, he became totally mad. She also left. The moment she, mother left, wife left, the whole village, what they thought, you know, Muruganantham having illegal connection with many girls, that's why she is having a sexual disease. Then a bad spirit entering into my body, I am becoming a vampire in the evening, drinking girls' blood. They want to chain my both the legs in a holy tree, ups and down. Cough fungi. They want to chase her from my village. Then if they chain my both leg, one fellow throw a stone on me, then they will kill me. All 100 people they will do. Already I saw the scene in my childhood. Then I thought somebody is planning to kill me. Then I ran away from my village. I stayed in a nearby village, nearby city. After 2.5 years, I understand what is the raw material used by big companies. Even after that, another problem, you need this multi-million dollar machine to process the particular material. You saw the white roll is the material, not the cotton. So I'm asking that second year MBA students in SPJIMR Institute, if you are trying to do something, it becomes harder, more harder, then it becomes a mountain, what you will do? Even faculty also you can join. You are trying to do something, it becomes harder, more harder, it becomes mountain, what you will do? Simply give up, surrender to your mother-in-law, something. But my philosophy is, if something you are trying to do, it becomes harder, more harder. That means it's a clear indication by Lord Shiva. Go ahead. If you do it, you will get accolade. The same, it became easy. Don't do it. Even you are doing it, you are nothing you are going to get. Or because of your student, I am saying like this. You are chasing a girl in this campus. Even chasing for 8 months, you are not able to get her mobile phone. The girl is perfect. You chase the girl for another 1 year. The same, you are chasing a girl for 10 minutes. She is stopping, is turning. You want my mobile number? See, it's dangerous, don't chase. Okay. So, I spent another 4.5 years on this method, a simple T&D method. Anyone want to do something new, you want to create new, even in management, only available method given by God is this. It cannot be taught. So it's nothing. No need to go to Stanford and for higher studies. It's nothing but a trial and error method. Because I did on my own money, sometime, many time I used to donate my blood in a government hospital for traveling expense money, because the whole world branded me as a madman. Who will finance? You know, MBA student, for research, something to create a new, you need fund. Funding, crowdfunding, non-crowdfunding, this crowdfunding. Who will give a fund for a madman? How I did? That's a separate subject. So that's what I did on my own money, something on my own. I'm very bravely saying in the crowd, I did this innovation on a trial and error method. The same if you are doing with a crowdfund or corporate or government tax, you can't say this. That's why they coined a word called this. Okay. So what they're doing, see, even the large-scale collider, somebody is trying to find out the goddess particle or god particle. Earlier they had a 24-kilometer tunnel, now they're seeking for 60-kilometer tunnel. They did nothing because they're doing on this way. You are DRDO, anything, somebody research, I know you are doing on trial basis, nothing. You take it grand. There is, if you are doing something in one stroke in perfect, that is called a routine work. If it is new, no one can come out with an error. It is called only this person. Why I am saying this? Don't afraid if you see R&D something, it is meant for Kalam and for ISROs. No, it is for everyone if you convert into this. See, a school dropout, I am doing something on this. Even you are come out from National Institute of Designing something, paying 1 crore per annum, the only choice given by God is trial error method. So out of it, I innovate this machine after day 1 to 7.5 years. On the cost of separation of my wife, family, everything. But even after finding, I sent the mission to IIT, this only place, where I found those days a man with French skirt wearing Bermuda and Nike shoes, a little bit afraid, because they used to shake their whole shoulder. Yeah, oh. I thought, now I'm traveling to London, no London people, they shake their hand. They are speaking from mouth. I thought, why you are not shaking? No need to shake shoulder to speak English. No, in India, everybody shaking the whole life. I said, oh, we don't know. So the stupid thing, don't do it. You do what you want exactly, world and your family you need. Don't do this thing. I never saw any American or German. Nobody is shaking that body. They are everyone speaking from mouth. Okay. Those day 10, 12 engineers, they are shaking their whole shoulder. They are criticizing something in the left hall because there is evaluation process going on. What they are criticizing, this is the English I am speaking from 2009 December in front of Ratan Tata. And Anil Amban, everybody sitting, 3,300 industrialists sitting, the same Mumbai. Up to that, I used to speak, somebody will, translator, what is the name? Interrupter or interpreter. They used to translate like a robot, the audience will not able to connect. That's why on the particular day, I said, I try my own. It is available on YouTube. Then even I'm able to understand what they're criticizing, why this fellow is taking this whole drive risk, he made a simple machine, what is it going to do with this? Because they're comparing how I'm going to compete with this machine, with the American company like Procter & Gamble and Johnson. Those days I'm having an answer in my mind, but there is no language. That's why I'm saying boldly, linguistic is no way connected with practical skill. Many people they will talk, they won't do. Many people they do, they won't talk. That's why I said in interview of 10 minutes, 15 minutes, you can't judge a client or a candidate. I said, you stupid, interview is useless. Why? What we are going to judge the practical skill? Practice is need. That's why they ask you, do you need experience? Like, why they're asking experience? Because somebody already spent their time, money. I'm skipping this. My answer for the engineer, I told I'm the son of a handloom weaver. My father and myself, we bought a handloom weaving machine 30 years back for 3,000 rupees, 90% made of wood. My father installed at my home, he made a handloom weaving sarees, he sold, we survived. Father, mother, myself, two younger sisters, we never die amid of 426 fully mechanized mill in my city, in Coimbatore. That means my father never used the small equipment to rub solder with mill owner. The same way I found in this machine, there is a capability of giving a livelihood for a woman. Then I took the machine to Bihar. So this is the mission, first mission I took to Madhupani district in Bihar, because anything you want to do a field trial, if you succeed in Patna, you can replicate any part of the world. Okay, I spoke the same. That's why I know if you succeed in Bihar, it will match. That's why I took, it is all by experience I know, because we are into textile. They are the stakeholders. No need to say these women are poor, but they branded as a Naxal's family, Maoist, nothing. I used to work with all Naxalites, Maoists, all militant. Because their brothers and fathers and husbands are bad. They are not. I set up them. I slowly did it for 4 or 5 years. Nobody knew. I took the mission on donkey's back. It is in Uttarakhand. From Dehradun, 18 hours near Rudraprayag. The Ganga is forming. Now the unit is not as collapsed in the recent flood. See? People are living in slum. Villages are situated in slum. How many villages come into Indian census? Nobody know. The back view, the Anandag and the Bhagirathi farming river. If you stay there for 2.5 months, walk on the tribal path, even if you are having cancer, you will get 6 packs here and the cancer will cure. Such a beautiful place. We are here, I told to Johnson's, this is called rural marketing, not doing something in suburban city. So to reach the place, Johnson will take another 25 years, Muruga is already there. Okay. See. And schools, the school girls are making their own pads like hot koli vada, like something. See, these school girls. I ended up with the President Award. The moment I got President Award, I lose my privacy. Then I become a speaker. Okay. So usually, if you thought about business, even in the institute, you are robust with retailing. Retailing, how to retailing, this retailing. Suddenly a fever happens out of Bunsell's and Jack Ma's. E-tailing, e-commerce, this commerce. Both these two models, if you are follow to in business, you can't do nothing, a millimeter change in society. If you want to enter into a particular field, you also need a lot of funds to compete that whales and sharks and buffaloes. But both the thing we are not following, retailing, e-tailing. We are following detailing. To do this method in something, you need a lot of manpower. You have to spend time. So no Bunsell's or Ginsell's compete me in this. But I don't get bills, no problem. We will going to get soon also. But detailing out of it, we created around 887 brands. In India only, that brand's able to compete Americans very good. That's why I am with speaking with Paul Polman, the CEO of Unilever. I gave a lecture to Polman and 77 CEOs. It's a close room session on the rural marketing. You see? Okay. The black coat is Sanjeev Mehta of Hindustan Unilever, executive chairman. Recently, the recent annual report of Hindustan Unilever, anyone sees, you can find my name. Arish Marwani, refer my name. In Hindustan Unilever annual report. You can refer. So this part. So this is called measuring your success, not telling yourself. So you just see. What I told, Polman, we created around 887 brands. We created around $230 million revenue without eating a single percentage of your market cake. That means you and your team of 77 CEOs, you missed this market for last 50 years. It's a total discrimination for your stakeholder, I told. They agreed. 200 million is nothing, but you missed for last half a century. They agreed. See? It's because it happened in Seattle. It happened in Seattle. So they called, I want to neglect, because in 50 days I traveled 5 times. In immigration in the US, they asked, what for your visiting? I said, to spend weekend days. Wow, you are coming for weekends. You are coming every 10 days. Yes. That's what I want to skip by. He sent a personal envoy with his signed letter. Please come. We will provide a red carpet welcome. Then I stayed in Westin Hotel. They provide a shoot. Whenever phone rings, I have to run for 3 rooms. Then I beg the reception. I am alone. Give me a single. No, stay. Everyone laughing at that. See, I think Susan, the CEO, MIT chief, everybody. MIT, Susan, the CEO of Gates Foundation, everybody is like, what I told there, I had no way connected with Gates or Windows. But only thing, I also made Windows in iron, I told. You see, I'm well done. Huh? I don't know where connected with the Gates or Gates Foundation, but one thing, I also made Windows in iron, I told. I'm well done. Huh? That's why I picked up a late. So this was. And this has become viral in Western countries because of that coming out a brand, that too in FMCG products, in IT boost this come. And I thought that this is the taboo only in developing nations. Now I'm getting mails from developed nations. They are not able to afford sanitary towels. It is a mail from US girl, and I'm getting a lot of. So what do you need to create a new organization or something, anything? No need an opportunity or money or nothing. All you need a problem, not an opportunity. So don't look for an opportunity. If I say in this hall, everyone get opportunity, it is a lie. And then I became a Guruji. Only Gurujis will say everybody will grow. Don't look for an opportunity. You don't get opportunity anywhere in the world. If it is lying, is there in here, it is already grabbed by mafia or politician something. In spite of looking for an opportunity, look for a problem. Now opportunities are lying in the form of problem and address with your small knowledge. I saw a problem, I converted into opportunity. That's why then I tried to build a company on a measure of social impact. So far, 2,000 machines set up in all over India. These are the names I got: frugal designing, disruptive designing, rural marketing. Somebody talk about a blue ocean strategy. There are big fish, there are small fish. They are not fighting each other. Oh my God, I'm doing it for 12 years. Everything I did, then I know what is blue ocean. No, we should not, I am doing that. Then finally they gave corporate bomber. I never put any bomb on anybody, but the world is giving corporate bomber. Okay. Then recently selected by Time magazine. I thought 4 people selected: Narendra Modi, our Prime Minister, Arvind Kejriwal, Arundhidra, and Muruga. Somebody will come, I can stand behind them because my linguistic. Then nobody is coming there, only me, I'm representing India. Because the moment you are crossing Atlantic Ocean, you are not Muruga, you are India. You are not school dropout, never bother, you are India. You see, everybody are coming. I am walking like Aishwarya Rai in a red carpet. Every step, I laugh under camera, take a photograph. Then they are bombarding question with stick mic. We feel Modi is Indian Putin. What's your opinion? If I say yes, if I landed at Madras, they will kill me, BJP people. Then they are asking, they stand on Sri Lanka that I can't say go and ask Manmohan Singh. Then finally, a woman is chasing all the crowd. They're coming, please, one. Why modeling is not picking up in India? What I guess, the girl is very crowd clearing. Muruga, why modeling is not picking up in India? Then I said, Santi is not interested. Somehow I managed that white background, red carpet. I'm going to the first floor. Again, there's a girl, they told it's a LH plus Muruga. Ordinary masala dosa, ordinary dosa, na? Dosa, like that. This is the ordinary press. Again, going with the we handle BBC, CNN, like that. So, you see, I can't ask repeat questions. This happened. So, the measure of social impact created, more than 20,000 women got a direct livelihood. We shipped around 10 million women from unhygiene method, hygiene method. The vision is creating a 1 million employment for women and making India an 100% sanitary emission country from the current level of less than 5% is a cumulative achievement of independence India from 47 to 2014 with 14 presidents, I don't know how many prime ministers, 578 MPs and millions of siren fitted vehicles. Whenever I stop at road, fleet of siren fitted vehicle going, I laugh, where you are going to make country into 5% advocate country. Even our team converting this into 10% in 10 years is the greatest achievement for us. Because LS5 stands for 50 years of independence India. And not only India, the design is very well matched for 106 developing nations. So far, we spread around 17 countries. That's why this is called Pink Revolution, and this is called Beyond Marketing. Thank you very much. Bye.